We'll be right back. We got a message off Charlotte as well. Happy Pride, Steph. Pride.
Borrowing this for a minute. That's all four records.
Okay.
I feel part of something.
Why do we celebrate? Why is it so important? For generations, we have had to live in hiding or reject who we are in order to protect ourselves.
with me.
Okay, I'm assuming we had more conversation with these people. Hey, just wanted to let you know I got home safe. Good. Thanks so much for this weekend. I didn't realize how badly I needed it until like right now. Now, hey, thank you. I think I kinda needed it too. You sure it's okay that I just like commanded your apartment for the whole weekend? Push, like I got nothing out of it. Lol, seriously, I had fun, me too. Oh hey, I found your bracelet. Welp, guess we're gonna have to hang out again so you can give it back to me. Darn, drat. Gold dang it. Gold dang it. Ah, beans. Friday, yep. Yours or mine? Mine, deal. Ugh, what a shitty night. Oh, bummer, what happened? Sure you have the bandwidth. I'm working, might be on and off tonight, but I'll check in when I can, okay? So I just got home from like the worst day ever. She was just immediately disengaged from the moment I sat down. She made eye contact with me like one time. She asked me if I was Gold Star. For fuck's sake. What? How is that any of her business? Thank you. Anyway, the whole night I kept thinking about how much I'd rather be with you. Thinking about how much dating sucks. And how lucky we got when we met each other. And I don't know, how maybe we should like have the what are we conversation. So, what are we, Steph? Hey, I am so sorry. I've just been swamped lately. I got kind of overwhelmed. I shouldn't have just disappeared like that. Okay. I think we had more conversation with the rest of these, so we'll go through these. So these conversations are advanced as well. So we got Fiona. I feel so bad that you're taking the bus back. I would have driven you. Lol, it's fine. I like the bus. By the way, can I just reiterate how fucking great you were on stage? Oh, total badass. Stop, don't stop, in brackets. Lol, that's sort of your comfort zone, isn't it? On stage? Yeah, like you were just so confident. I don't know, I guess so. It's nice when the words are written down for you beforehand. It's easy to be cool and brave when you know exactly how everything is going to turn out. Harder to do that in real life. Maybe you're right, I used to think I loved not knowing what was coming. You know, you say that a lot. I used to. Wow, read for filth after one date. Sorry, I didn't mean anything by it. You know, you say that a lot. Sorry, joke. Sorry for picking on you, in brackets. Same, in brackets. So wait, quick question, if that's okay. Shoot, when we played KNC on Saturday, you fudged the rolls, didn't you? What? How dare you? Oh yeah, a little, but only because you would have totally eaten shit against that arch ogre. Lol, well thank you, you're like a really good GM, you know. Haha, I didn't know about all that. Still pretty rusty, but it was fun. If the opportunity arises, hey, just poking you to make sure you see. Sorry to bug you, I just want to know if I should make other plans. You must be busy, maybe next weekend. Hey, shit, sorry, yeah, it's been kinda crazy over here, try for next week. Sure, hey, are we still on for this weekend? Hey, I got a flake, I'm sorry. Okay, can I ask what's up? Nothing major, just can't get coverage at work. Okay, hit me up when you have some time. Death. I don't think Colby... Yeah, Colby didn't, there wasn't any more interaction with Colby. Again, there wasn't any more interaction with Cal. Caitlin, again. And then Bubbles was, a bot. Okay, we got some new choices again. Liz, 33, Colorado Springs. CO, yes, it hurt. Jocelyn, 26, Thornton. CO, not so much a gym rat as a gym weasel. Rita, 29, Boulder. CO, let's not waste each other's time. Keep swiping for now. Hattie, 28, Denver, CO, who put the ram in the Ramalan Gading Dong. Tori, 22, Greeley, CO, check out my synth wave project, Witch Holiday. CC21 Colorado Springs, CO, this user hasn't entered a tagline yet, how mysterious. Keg25 Shady Creek Run, CO, I'm Keg. Nothing more than a basic, obvious summary of your profile, I guess. Corin, 30, Boulder, CO, this user hasn't entered a tagline yet, how mysterious. Shana, or Shana, 25, Boulder, CO. Low-key, disability activist, high-key, homosexual. And Twyla, I'd say that's Twyla. 21 Aspen CO, this user hasn't entered a tagline yet, how mysterious.
Fuck you, Matt.
Okay. So we got Tori and Rita.
Get it together, Steph. Best foot forward.
Make the first move, wait for her, make the first move.
Man,
we're always going to make the first move.
What do I even say?
Ask about her music. Actually, forget it. Ask her about her hair. Ask about her music. Yeah. Dope setup. What style of music do you make? Oh God, you're going to think I'm so pretentious. Try me. It's like partway between EDM and experimental bedroom synth pop. Sounds cool, sounds pretentious, sounds cool. Whatever, that sounds rad as hell. Thank you, I'm playing in Fort Collins next weekend, you should come. Would if I could, but I'm working all weekend. Hey, can I ask you something? Shoot, did you used to be in a band? Why or yeah? We'll go for yeah. I was for a while, yeah, I thought so. Two-piece, kind of punky, kind of alt. Drugstore makeup, that's it. Holy shit, I saw y'all in SLC at Atomic Decay. Or Atomic Decay. That's crazy, what are the odds? How'd you like the show? What were you doing in SLC? How'd you like the show? So what did you think? You were good. I had like an immediate crush on your guitarist, lol. Cute, ouch. Cute. Oh, Izzy's a cool person. I'd offer to introduce you, but we're really not on speaking terms. I'm sorry to hear that. Anyway, whatever. I'm talking to you, not her. So what are you up to these days? No more band. Chilling in Haven Springs, DJing at a radio station. I have no idea. DJing at a radio station. I'm DJing at a little radio station these days. That sounds cool. Yeah, I get to force my musical taste down everyone's throat, which is pretty sick. The dream, well, I should get going. It was cool to get to talk to you. Your band was really good. Say goodbye, ask her out. Gonna get drinks sometime? I don't think that's a good idea. Okay, why not? Did I do something wrong? No, it's not like that. You're cool. It's just that Haven Springs is a billion miles away, but I'm super glad we got to chat. Me too, whatever. Me too. Yeah, same. Maybe we'll see each other around. Maybe. Okay. At least she was on the dating app for a reason. She wasn't trying to make friends. She was trying to actually.
Yeah, but why swipe if they live millions of miles away from you?
That's a good point, actually. My only assumption is she knew that. Well, no, she didn't know the band either, did she?
No.
Good assumption. Good point. But, yeah, all right, you've got a point there. But at least she was on a dating app today. Do you know what I mean? Not to be friends with people. But you do have a good point there, and you know, if you are miles away and you aren't gonna work, look at the profile and don't swipe in it, you know what I mean? Right, we got Rita.
I really don't feel up to playing this game right now.
Make the first move.
I should put on a happy face and play nice, but God, I don't know if I have the energy.
Play nice, be real. Play nice. Yo, you seem really cool. Doing anything dope for Halloween? Damn, that's a lot of exclamation points. Yeah, I guess it is. Not really a Halloween kind of girl, but I take it you are. I love Halloween, just making conversation. I love Halloween. Sure, Halloween rules. How do you not like Halloween? Don't have the time for it, living that grad school life. Oh, dang, would now be a bad time to mention that I dropped out of undergrad. Oh, a dropout. You want to dig into that story? That's real shit. Tell me about your regrets. Tell me about your fears. Tell me about your passion. Tell me about your fears. Let's go with that one. Okay, you want to get real? Tell me something real about Rita then. What are you afraid of? The collapse of society? Fair point. You and I have very different priorities. Look, I'm not proud of it. I have no practical skills. I have a bachelor's degree in fucking marketing, and I'm about 6 months away from a master's. I know how to sell shit to people. If I'm ever placed in a position where I have to contribute selflessly to a community and build everything from the ground up, I am fucked. Never learned how. never too late to stop. Kind of think it might be your turn, tell me about your fears. Never feeling satisfied, some big tragedy in my future. Some big tragedy in my future. For the record, I have no idea why I'm going along with this. Fine, I'm scared of something horrible happening. Boring, everyone is scared of something horrible happening. It's not just that, okay, I'm scared that if I let my guard down, whatever is coming is going to blindside me. So what if it does? You get back up and you move on. Or you don't. Maybe you can't figure out how to be who you used to be anymore. Maybe everything that used to feel good and comfortable suddenly becomes not that. And then what? How do you get up and move on from that? Steph, that literally happens to everyone. What makes you special? Ouch. Why is she actually being an arsehole? Why are you being an arsehole? Please stop. I'm going to keep it polite. You know, if she carries on, we're going to fuck her off. Look, I gather this is just a Rita thing. The whole brutal honesty, keep it real bit. But I'm super not feeling it. Can you let up a little? I thought you were having fun. I'm not. I was. Fuck, it was fun at first, and maybe on a different day I'd be down. You just caught me on the worst possible day. I didn't realise you want to come over. Excuse me. Do you want to come over to my place? After all that, you don't have to. Absolutely not. I can't believe I'm doing this. Fuck it. I can't believe I'm doing this, but I'll message you when my shift ends. Deal. I got a feeling I'm going to regret this one. Well, we'll see. What do you reckon? Alright, let's... Got a message off Mikey. Okay, he's sent a shit ton of messages. Right, did you get that package I sent you? Dude, it has been way too long. I'm straight up hype about murdering Elamon again. Lol, classic Steph Gingrich. Yo, did you still want to chat later, Steph? Alright, well, guess I'll assume something came up. Hit me up when you get this. Been a few days, you okay? Dude, you got me kind of worried. And I really want to talk to you, especially since tomorrow is... Well, you know what tomorrow is. Hit me up. Alright, what are the things to do? And what are the notes to self this time? So we still got the listen to the original song, tally foosball score, and add to the Ethan's drawing. Read all ads, answer two calls, complete record. So we've got basically the exact same.
Hey there, you're live on KRCT, and I'm not alone in the universe. Who's this?
Hey, it's Gabe.
It's everyone's favorite bartender.
Made any resolutions? How's the lantern? Made any resolutions?
What are your resolutions and how many have you already broken?
Yeah, I was actually hoping to get your take on one of them.
Great. Let me throw in a song and then call you.
No, I meant... I called the show so I could talk to the psychic.
Oh. All right. What's on your mind?
There's someone in my family who might be totally alone right now. I've been thinking of reaching out to her. The thing is, it's been 7 years, and all that time I never got in touch.
Maybe you weren't ready, why not?
Maybe you weren't ready yet. Maybe if you had, it wouldn't have helped either of you.
No, look, the truth is, I'm terrified of talking.
Not like what I'm seeing.
Really?
What would be tough for Gabe, but in a good way?
Serious commitment, accepting the guilt. Accepting the guilt.
You give her a call. She's surprised but really glad to hear from you. You start catching up, and at first it's wonderful. The more you hear about her life and what she's been doing these past 7 years, the guiltier you feel.
You overcompensate, you beat yourself up. You beat yourself up.
You stop really listening to her. You're too busy blaming yourself for every little thing she talks about.
Yeah.
But then, you remember what a psychic on the radio once told you. You can't make the guilt go away. Stop trying. So you focus on her needs instead of yours, and you quickly realize she doesn't give a crap about how you feel. She cares about what you do. You decide to step up and act like the big brother you should have been. You make sure talking to you is a good part of her day. You give her advice when she wants it, and shut up when she doesn't. You talk about her future, find a place for her in your life here. And one day, you look at her in her hiking boots and Colorado sweatshirt, laughing at something you did. And you realize you completely forgot to feel guilty.
Thanks.
Thank you for calling.
How's the station? You lonely over there?
Honestly, no. Things are pretty great.
Okay. Then I'll see you.
Read ads, play songs, take calls. I'm a fully automated DJ.
Okay. All right, we've got a few messages again. Okay, this is from Ethan. So we're going to read out our SMSs first this time. New issue is done. Sick. When do I get copies for the shop? I can probably bring you some tomorrow. Heck yes. See you then. Okay. Hey, thank you for, I don't know, talking sense into me last night, I guess. We talk sense into each other. Lala said basically nothing. Hard disagree for the first time in a long time. I felt like I was actually talking to you. How are you feeling about it today? I don't know, better, less haunted, I guess. That's good, that's a start. So Element is coming back to New Eden after this campaign is over, right? He better. There's more unexplored buildings in that one city than all of our campaigns from high school. Sure, but like, Elamon isn't gonna crash every poor farmer's house looking for loot. I'm talking about the buildings underground. There's an underground winky emote. Oh dang, how's life in the sticks, by the way? Still thinking about splitting? Hey, I don't know, no time soon. Haven's alright. It's not like where I see myself retiring, but I like it here for now, I think. Like, I don't know, you know how horror games have safe rooms where the monsters can't get you and you have a chance to heal up and reload before you go back out to blast the skulls off some more zombies. Lol, I'll take your word for it, not my genre. Well, Haven Springs is my safe room, I think. Reload, heal up, and then back into the big dangerous world. Good luck healing up. I wouldn't want to be the first zombie to cross your path once you do. Chick, chick, blam. Okay, Izzy's talking again. Hey, hi. So I unblocked you. Yeah, you sure did, lol. I just found this out. I just found this and thought you might want a copy. Oh wow, that's a really good pick of us. Lol, I know, right? I look hot. Lol, you really do. Man, what a good day. Huh. Yeah, anyway, hit me up if you're ever back in Seattle. I will. Gabe, Ryan and Charlotte chat. So this is probably going to have a lot said since the last time, because we've gone from Halloween to Christmas now. Read all that. Are you gonna pay him the 50 bucks you owe him, or okay, who drew on the Laserdisc standby? Somebody drew on the Laserdisc standby? I would never. Lol, I'm not mad, this shit is hilarious. What's it say? I'll show you next time you come by the shop, it's perfect. I just noticed and about peed myself laughing. Just trying to figure out who to congratulate on a job well done. Wasn't me, man, you know I'd take credit. I've cleaned up too much trail graffiti. I would have died of guilt. Sure, you're being mysteriously quiet. Long live Laser Duck. Okay. And then again with Gabe, we got a lot to talk through. Don't you like any excuse me. My voice is starting to crack. Don't you like any normal movies? Not really, lol. Dude, do you have my copy of The Sword of Dust and Daylight? Oh yeah, lol, I totally forgot. I borrowed that. Oh, thank God. So that's not technically mine, it's technically Ethan's. And he gets back from his dad's tomorrow and like, he'll be pissed if we can't play it together. Lol, I'll swing by with it after work. You're a total champ, best punk band go. X-ray specs. Lol, you're so wrong, it's obviously the Misfits. Normie says what? Best cartoon character go. Hot dog man, correct. Best breakfast food go? Biscuits and gravy smothered with hot sauce. How are you gonna do pancakes like that? SMDH. Look, I love a good pancake. I will go to town on a fat sack of those suckers. But let's not kid ourselves, pancakes are a dessert food. What? I don't even know who I'm talking to right now. They're sweet, they're sticky, they have no nutritional value. Oh, I'm sorry, and biscuits and gravy are a superfood. Whatever, you know the rules. We can only argue for 30 seconds per topic. Best place in Haven to have a picnic go? The park. The pier. Come on, man. Oh, okay, yeah. I changed my answer. Lol. Okay, time out. Gotta get ready for work. Or the SMSs. Did anything else come off these? All right, so we have new conversation with Violet. So, hey, holy shit, hey, how are you? Good, you know, it's Taurus season, so Telluride is crawling with ski bros. How are you? Yeah, I'm not bad, actually. Got invited to GM a LARP. Yeah, of course you did. Haha, of course you did, I mean. I've been thinking a lot about how things ended, kind of sucked, huh? I mean, it could have been way worse. I could have spoken a lot better. Lol, yeah, I guess so. I just started seeing someone new. It's going really well, and I like her so much. But like, I don't know. You and I had so much fun. I miss you. I miss you too. Wanna be bros? What kind of dyke would I be if my friend group wasn't primarily composed of exes? A valid point. Congrats, by the way, you deserve to be happy. How's that all going for you? Lol, what, dating? Think I'm taking myself off the market, honestly, at least for now. That might end up being really good for you. I'll definitely get more done if I'm not staring at this app all day. All damn day, that's for sure. Hey, I'm glad we're bros now. Me too. Sorry. Okay, did anything else happen with these people? We're just going to keep going right through each one. Fiona didn't say anything back. Interesting. So we've only really had Violet that we've had really kept in conversation. Do just want to check something, guys. Right, we've got some more. It came up on my stream that there was a network error, so I'm not too sure why that came up, even though I've just double checked my stream, and obviously it's still showing that I'm live. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just going to end it on this stream, and I'm going to come back to it in just literally a second, just so I make sure that I don't, obviously there isn't anything else playing up. So I'll see you very soon.